Are we even talking about the same thing right now? Welcome to Critical Thinking Scan, where we look at how you can think about any faith-challenging message and arrive at a biblical, logical conclusion yourself. I'm Patricia Engler, and today I'm going to unpack check number 4 of the 7 checks of critical thinking which any Christian can use, based on the techniques that helped me as a Christian student at secular university. And check number 4 for thinking critically about any message is check the definitions. See, sometimes words that sound the same can carry multiple meanings. For instance, I used to work at a greenhouse, where one day I remember a gentleman walked up to me and asked, "Do you have time?" Now, he might have been asking whether I had time to answer a question, but I thought he might have been checking what time it was. So I said, "Oh yes, sir, it's 3:15. And he was like, no, time. So I said, "Yes, sir, it's 3:15. So he started spelling T-H-Y-M-E, and I realized that he was looking for the plant called thyme. Now, thyme and time are different words, even though they sound the same. But sometimes even the same word can have multiple meanings which need clarification. Words carry different ideas in different contexts, or they mean different things to different people. And some words like person, science, religion, and evolution are prime examples. I took entire classes about evolution, and when my textbooks gave examples of evolution we can see happening, it was always evolution in the sense of what we, from a biblical perspective, would view as variation within the original kinds of living things that God created, like finches. In my biology classes, we talked about how mutations and natural selection can let finches with long beaks give rise to finches with short beaks. And that's cool. But like you can learn more about through other Answers in Genesis resources, including some of the ones linked to this video, mutation and natural selection can't actually produce the types of changes required to evolve one kind of living creature into another. So while my textbook's called Variation in Finch Beaks, Evolution, it's not an example of evolution in the sense of change between kinds, like dinosaurs evolving into finches. But you know, textbooks will tell you these things are equal. They'll say, "Oh, we can see finches evolving into finches, therefore we know dinosaurs evolved into finches." But did you catch what happened there? The definition of evolution switched. If you notice the definition switching like that during an argument, you've detected a type of fallacy, a faulty form of reasoning called bait and switch or equivocation. And another really common word besides evolution that often gets equivocated is science. As you can learn more about in the links provided, people often use science as a catch-all word when there are really two very important different types of science. The first, observational science, involves making measurements in the present, using the scientific method to describe what we're seeing in the world around us right now. This type of science deals with facts. Historical science, on the other hand, involves interpreting facts from the present to draw conclusions about the past. And this kind of science deals with assumptions. For instance, while the size and mass and species description of a fossil would be facts from observational science, the assumption that that fossil formed millions of years ago would be an interpretation from historical science. And textbooks often blur the lines between these two types of science. For instance, one of my own textbooks said that evolution is as much a scientific fact as the atomic constitution of matter or the revolution of Earth around the sun. Now, the Earth's revolution is something that we can measure with observational science. And even prominent evolutionists like Ernst Mayr have pointed out that a lot of evolutionary biology is historical science. So watch out for equivocation and always define your terms. That's check number 4 of the 7 checks of critical thinking. For more on how to think critically about any faith-challenging message, you can access my other CT scan videos packed with tactics, tips, and tools that helped me as a Christian student at secular university. Thank you for watching.
Hey
Hey, it's Patricia here. Just wanting to let you know that if you like these videos, a free, easy way to help Answers in Genesis Canada create more content and equip more people to defend their faith is to hit that like button, subscribe to our channel, click the bell, and of course, share these resources. That lets the social media algorithms help these videos reach more people who can benefit from them, saving us advertising expenses while promoting biblical authority. Thank you so much.